Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. This is the day that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. I want to share a word with you today to encourage you in the Lord. From the gospel according to St. Matthew chapter number 6, beginning with verse number 25 through 34. You'll find these words, and I am grateful that God continues to bless us and to bring us together. And I want to speak life over your situation. I want to speak health and strength over your body and over your mind. Don't allow the troubles of the world to get you down. Hallelujah. Don't allow the troubles of this world to get you down. Matthew 6, beginning with verse number 25 through 34. Therefore, I say to you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, nor about your body, what you will put on. Is not life more than food and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air, for they neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Or are you not of more value than they? Which of you, by worrying, can add one cubit to his stature? So why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. And yet I say to you that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Now if God so clothes the grass of the field, which today is, and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, O you of little faith? Therefore, do not worry, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what shall we wear? For after all these things the Gentiles seek, for your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about its own things. Sufficient for the day is its own trouble. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, we thank you for life, health, and strength. We thank you for every mountain and every valley. We thank you, dear God, for every obstacle and every victory. We thank you that weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. Be with us, dear God, as we share your word, as we hear your word. We pray in the name of Jesus, that you, through your word, through your divine love and wisdom, that you will help us to navigate our way on life's journey. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Don't allow the troubles of this world, the problems, the disappointments that you face to get the best of you. God says in this word from Jesus Christ, as Matthew shares in the gospel, Matthew 6, it reminds us not to worry. My brothers and sisters, do not worry. God is still in control. Do not worry. Remember what God has done for you in the past. He's the same God, and he never changes. He's able to do it again and again, but we must put our total trust in him. The gospel reminds us through Jesus, do not worry. He says, do not worry about our clothing. Do not worry about our food. Lord, have mercy. The word of God reminds us that instead of worrying, that we should seek the kingdom of God first and all his righteousness and all these things, all the things that we want, all the things that we need. God is saying that he will provide. Hallelujah. Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow. Don't even worry about tomorrow. I know that if you worry, it can cause stress. I know that if you worry, you can begin to become angry. You can get sick. Some people blame other people for their problems or their problems not being solved. But the Lord tells us in his word, do not worry. Lord have mercy. I'm so glad. I'm so glad. The Lord reminds us in his word that he looks after the birds. And if he looks after the birds, he's able to look after us. He's able to supply our needs. The Bible reminds us not to worry about clothing. It says, consider the lilies of the field, how they grow, and they neither toil nor spin. Do not worry. If God takes care of the lilies of the field, and you are his child, don't you know that God is able to take care of you? Don't you know that God cares enough about you to take care of you? I'm reminded, and I'm fascinated as I am reminded about a 19th century leader by the name of George Mueller. George Mueller. I want to share a little bit of George Mueller's story, and you can find it in many different places, but I want to share with you just a little bit about George Mueller. George Mueller is considered a prayer warrior. He did not become a prayer warrior overnight. George, as a matter of fact, didn't come to the Lord till after he had lived as a sinner for 20 years. But there's a story about George Mueller going to a prayer meeting and being moved after seeing how the warriors, those who were in prayer, were committed to prayer and seeing how God had began to answer their prayer. Mueller took it upon himself to become a prayer warrior, and God changed his life. There are some things that George went through that tested his faith. You'll go through some things. I'll go through some things that would test our faith. It'll test our faithfulness to God. It'll test our prayer life, our commitment to God, commitment to prayer. But we're reminded in the scripture, do not worry. We're reminded in the scripture that God takes care of the lilies of the valley. We're reminded in the scripture that God takes care of the little birds. We're reminded that God will take care of us. I want to share a little bit about George Mueller. This man, without a doubt, was one of the most significant men of the 19th century. He was known as God's millionaire or the 19th century apostle with good reason. When on March 10th, 1898, he closed his eyes to the world forever, he had his lifetime prayed for roughly, he had prayed roughly for $23 million. For the construction of orphanages, support for orphanages, distribution of Bible and tracts, support for missionaries, and the maintenance of schools. These are things that we still are drawn to do. We still are led to do. We still believe that we should help those who are in orphans. We believe that we should distribute Bibles and tracts. We still believe that we should support missionaries and maintain schools and help children. But the Bible tells us, do not worry. If you have a ministry where you need some of these things, George Mueller is an example to you. He's an example to me. He prayed, he asked his Heavenly Father for these things. The Bible says, we have not because we ask not. The Bible says, ask and it shall be given. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the door shall be open. When considering such a huge accomplishment, the question arises, what prepared this man for such an enormous task? Perhaps he was the son of or the grandson of a devoutly religious preacher or man of prayer. Oddly enough, this assumption would be completely erroneous. Up until his 20th year, he was living a sinful and wicked life, as I said earlier. One day he was invited to a Bible study, which was held in the home of a businessman, where he was greatly amazed. People knelt in prayer and openly prayed from the heart. This made such an impression on him that without delay, he also started to pray. He did not rest until he had the assurance of God's acceptance and the forgiveness of his sins. Lord have mercy. What a mighty man. After his conversion, George Mueller had one goal: to consecrate his life to the service of the Lord. He studied theology and traveled in England in 1826 as a missionary to the Jewish people. Soon thereafter, he preached the word, serving in a small church. Since it was so problematic in 1830 for this little flock to provide a regular wage for him, he proposed to rely solely on his Lord to provide for his daily bread. During this time, he often encountered people who had to work 14 to 16 days and naturally could not muster enough desire and energy at the end of their shift to study God's word and strengthen themselves in prayer. When he admonished these people to work less, trust God more, and care for the needs of their souls, they would often reply, "What does prayer help? If we don't work, we have no food." That always cut into George's heart, and he wrestled prayerfully with thoughts of how he could prove to these people that the scripture still was true. He read and thought about Matthew 6 and 33, "But seek thee first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you." The result was that George found it in this scripture encouragement, support, and faith. Shortly thereafter, his orphanage venture followed. It must be noted that Mueller strived to glorify God, the one who answers prayers above all, to prevent anyone from saying that he might secretly rely on wealth, friends, or donors. He determined to never apply to any charity for monetary support. He also decided not to share the status of his bank account. He resolved to completely and totally trust in God. How did God respond? He revealed himself to the prayers of his faithful servant. George received donations amounting anywhere from 2 cents to $188,000. He was as thankful for the first amount as for the latter. At times, his bank account accumulated tens of thousands, while there were other times when he didn't know at the beginning of the day where he would find money to pay for the midday meal. However, there was never a time when his children gathered for a meal and he had nothing to give them. God always provided his help at exactly the right time. I'm reminded of the song that says, I think by James Cleveland said, "Where is your faith?" I question you today. I want you to seek God. I want you to pray to God. I want you to believe that God will deliver you. I want you to believe that God will supply your needs. Whatever resources you need, whatever problems you have, we have an example in George Mueller that believed in the power of prayer, believed in the God that answers prayer. We're reminded in the scripture to seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. Put God first. Pray and ask God to bless your ministry, to bless your family, to bless whatever is on your heart. The scripture reminds us to delight ourselves in the Lord, and he will give us the desires of our heart. I encourage you, brothers and sisters, today to trust God through your process. Watch him turn it around, and you'll be able to give a testimony about the goodness of the Lord. You will be encouraged, and you will be able to encourage others. You will be blessed, and you will be a blessing to others. My time is up, my brothers and sisters, but I encourage you to walk by faith and not by sight. I encourage you to be a doer of the word and not a hearer only. Eternal God, we thank you for what our ears have heard, what our hearts have felt, and what our minds were able to conceive. We pray that you would continue to bless us and keep us in the name of Jesus. We pray that we be faithful in our prayer life, in our patience, and in our courage. God, we surrender all in Jesus' name. Amen. May the Lord bless you and may the Lord keep you, is my prayer.